A 30-year-old woman with no chronic diseases has pneumonia. Just as her doctor is about to prescribe oral amoxicillin in accordance with the guidelines, he asks her one final question. Are you perhaps allergic to any drugs? And of course she says, yes, penicillin. Of course. Now, what should the doctor do? A. Prescribe azithromycin, B. Cefuroxim, C. Levofloxacin, or E. None of the above. Pause for a second to think, and please click the like button if this format of teaching works for you, and I will make more of these clinical cases. Now back to our question. Well, this is a trick question because at this point, the doctor should make an effort to extract more information before making the final decision. Allergy to penicillin is serious business, and we should not label our patient as allergic just like that. Penicillins and other beta-lactams like cephalosporins and carbapenems are by far the most widely used antibiotics. For good reason. They are effective, safe, well-tolerated, and for so many diseases, they are by far the best option. Far superior to the next best thing. So, if your patient is allergic to these drugs, this can pose a very big problem if they come down with a serious infection. So, when the patient mentions that they are allergic, be sure to ask them exactly what they mean. Do they remember the exact name of the drug and when did this allergic reaction happen? And what did it look like? Was it a true hypersensitivity reaction or merely a side effect like mild nausea or diarrhea? So, ask them about the symptoms and signs of type 1 IgE-mediated reactions and delayed severe systemic reactions. In other words, were there hives or another severe generalized rash? Were there signs of angioedema like a swollen tongue, lips, or eyelids? Was there a sense of choking or difficulty breathing? This is how IgE-mediated reactions manifest, and they typically occur minutes to hours after the drug is administered. Delayed hypersensitivity reactions, on the other hand, can occur many days or several weeks after exposure to the offending drug. There are several different types of these delayed reactions, so be sure to ask about some common telltale signs like a severe generalized non-blanching rash and especially painful ulcerous lesions involving mucosal surfaces like the oral cavity, the conjunctiva, and the genital mucosa. In addition, ask about systemic signs like fever and involvement of major organs like lungs, liver, or kidneys. If none of this was present, it's quite unlikely that your patient is truly allergic. Conversely, if they did have one of these severe reactions, believe me, they will know. Oftentimes, the patient will tell you that they think they might have had an allergic reaction to penicillin in their childhood, but it was a long time ago and they cannot remember exactly. The good thing about hypersensitivity is that it wanes over time. So, even if they did have a reaction in childhood, there is more than an 80% chance that they are not allergic anymore if more than 10 years have passed. Not to mention that if you ask them about specific drugs like amoxicillin, amoxicillin clavulanate, or piperacillin, many times they will tell you that they did actually take these drugs in the meantime and everything was fine. This means, obviously, that they are not allergic to penicillins after all. But you won't know that unless you ask those detailed questions. Don't assume that your patients know which drugs belong to the group of penicillins or what constitutes a true hypersensitivity reaction. You know, especially if you've gone through my course on antibiotics, but most of your patients probably don't. Why would they? In short, when they tell you that they are allergic, don't take that at face value and ask them a few more questions to get to the bottom of this. What kind of reaction was it and did it correspond to a type 1 IgE-mediated reaction or a severe delayed systemic reaction? What was the name of the drug that triggered it? Have they taken any similar drugs? Be sure to offer them exact names. And finally, have they perhaps done any tests to determine whether or not they are truly allergic? Speaking of which, when in doubt, do suggest testing because allergy to penicillins is a serious limitation and it could prove extremely important for your patient in the future. This is the kind of stuff you will learn in my online course on antibiotics. In the description of this video, you will find the link to the demo version that contains the first few crucial lessons that explain the most important group of antibiotics and provide a great foundation for everything that follows. If you use antibiotics in clinical practice, this course will make your life so much easier. I hope to see you there. Take care.